Hello, this is Candid Charcha and I am Renzi Thomas. We have a superb and exciting guest who is also the youngest coach of skydiving and an amazing person. So today's topic of discussion is skydiving, which it's the safest extreme sport. So, and the guest is none other Mr. Rudra Bhanu Solanki. He is the youngest skydiving coach. He is the founder of Sky High India. It's the international skydiving drop zone. He is also a paramotor pilot and an avid traveler. So let's welcome Rudra on board. Hi Rudra.
Hi Renzi. Thank you so much for inviting me. It is a real honor and a pleasure to be here.
It's our pleasure that you took out some time to be with us and to talk about this sport. It's going to be fun, and it's actually, as you say, it's extreme se jada, it's exciting sport actually.
Yes, absolutely, and I think time is a luxury that we all have nowadays, so we can make some good
actually,
use of it.
Actually, yeah.
What better to talk in skydiving?
Rudra, I think to get some, I saw your, the video which you have kept it ready to show.
Yes,
probably,
so,
yeah, so
to introduce the sport, Renzi. I think most people understand what skydiving is basically jumping out of a perfectly good aeroplane, and people think that we are crazy that we jump out of aeroplanes, which is absolutely fine.
Right.
Whereas it's not the truth. The idea is to push the human body to whatever we can achieve, and the longing to achieve more and more is what keeps us skydivers going.
Right.
For a simple understanding on what a first time skydive looks like, I'm going to quickly show you one video.
Yeah. I think yeah, that will be great.
Okay. There you go.
Amazing, exciting. I think this is this is the coolest start we can have actually, Rudra. So Rudra, you know, you yourself is an inspiration, being the youngest civilian skydiver and also the coach of India. Rudra, what was the story like? How did you I would like to know what was the motivation behind, and how did you start up your journey as a skydiver?
So, like I said, I started skydiving in the year 2012. I had the opportunity to go to a place in the US called Arizona, Skydive Arizona. It's one of the biggest drop zones in the world. And as a kid, I always knew that I wanted to, it was something in my bucket list to go skydiving once. But obviously, I didn't plan it like this. What is really ironic is that as a kid, I also knew that when I have to go skydiving ever in my life, even once, I have to travel across the world to do it. So I did. I went to the US in 2012 and I got my A license into skydiving. I got introduced to this beautiful sport. But as I was being introduced, this thought really occurred to me that this sport is not as easily accessible to people in India. And it's not just a sport, it's actually a way of life, of being. The freedom of being the way we are. It really made me think and really took some time for me to understand that, yes, this is an opportunity and a chance to get something beautiful back into India. So I did. I went back again to the US, understood a little bit about skydiving, and then I came into India and suddenly I had, you know, the swarm of ideas that I was going through, that okay, it's going to be like this and like that and like this and like that. And then I actually ended up trying to apply for skydiving permissions. And that's, I think, where everything changed for me, because I figured that there was actually no regulation, proper regulation in India at the time for skydiving. While skydiving was being conducted, it was primarily being done under the aegis of like the Air Force or the Indian Army. Very limited options available in the civilian side. So I said, well, okay. So it actually took a very big turn in my journey as a skydiver, because from trying to actually just follow the sport into becoming an excellent skydiver myself, I actually ended up now going back again to World Drop Zone Operators meets and traveling the globe, trying to understand the commercial side of skydiving and you know, how the economics of it works. And you know, I actually ended up, from doing skydiving, I started studying skydiving. And that changed phenomenally, because suddenly, you know, from instead of jumping out of planes, I had books in my hands. I was trying to study regulation across the globe. And then, yeah, and then it took me a few years, actually. I applied for the permissions in 2014 and kept on struggling. And finally, in the year 2016 is when we got our first approval to do something here in India. So yeah, started the first facility at Aligarh, which is 2 hours away from New Delhi. Continued there for 2 years and realized that, okay, we had to grow bigger. And because we were sharing the airspace with some other flying schools, we decided now in the year 2018 to take up an independent. And as of last year, we've moved to a new place. It's called Narnaul. Narnaul is 2 hours southwest of Delhi. It's a dedicated airstrip to aerosports. Right now, the only available aerosport is skydiving. So yeah, that's where we are now, doing jumping every weekend, having lots of fun. So yeah, that's where we are now.
Rudra, so when you went for skydiving in Arizona, where you did you knew that you are going to be a coach after, or was that your like after starting diving you decided to be a coach?
I'll be honest with you. I had some idea about you know, skydiving before that. I studied a lot, and I met somebody who was my mentor back in the day. His name is Colonel Verma. If you Google him, he's a much avid skydiver than I am.
Okay.
And when I did start talking to him about skydiving and how, you know, what is skydiving and all, he just wrote me this name on a piece of paper called Skydive Arizona, and he said that, you know, if you really want to talk about anything to do with skydiving, the first thing you need to do is become a skydiver. So he recommended the place to me. Thank you, Parma sir, if you're listening. And so, yeah, and so I went, and I the next call I made to him was from Arizona, and he was like, okay, well, there's somebody who's serious about what they're talking about. So I sort of knew about the place, but I had not actually so much as seen a skydive before this. And this was actually even before the movie Zindagi Na Milegi Dobara, if you would remember, because that suddenly changed the perception of skydiving in India.
Right,
so
that, that movie, in fact, changed a lot of perceptions of common people's thought towards adventure, let it be any extreme sport.
Absolutely.
The movie was a turning point for, just like few movies changed Three Idiots, it changed Ladakh.
Yeah.
This movie actually changed a lot of people's perception towards adventure.
Absolutely.
Rudra, jitna mujhe pata hai, like most of these skydivers who I have seen or heard are people from special forces or from Air Force or something, like who has a defense background. But you, yeah, being a young civilian, was it easy to go and study and become a skydiver, or like in terms of monetary and also in terms of knowledge and training, time, everything? Was it easy journey, or
easy for normal people? I think the most difficult part about my skydiving journey was getting permission from my parents. to actually go skydiving. Everything else after that felt like a cakewalk. Because like I told you, it was long before the movie Zindagi Na Milegi Dobara. And the concept or the idea of skydiving was very alien in a country like ours. Whatever we knew of skydiving was only pretty much that, yes, it's something that the army does and maybe happens in the Western world. So yeah, so once I managed to convince my parents that yes, this is what I wanted to do, everything else slowly kept falling into place. Yes, it is a very, very extremely expensive sport. So that's something to keep in mind whenever you do consider skydiving. For the simple reason that we use aircrafts and we are burning fuel in aircrafts, the aircraft itself costs a lot of money.
Correct.
And the second reason is that the equipment we use is very, very sophisticated. It's taken all these 60, 70 years of world skydiving and a lot of blood and a lot of effort into developing the parachute systems that we use today. And they are probably the safest parachute systems that are available ever in the world and that are available to everyone who isn't into skydiving. I'll tell you more about the equipment we use when we do talk about how skydiving
correct,
is actually...
Correct. Of course, I would love to listen to all those things because, you know, yes. Me, I'm very sure all of our viewers also would like to know more about the sport and how safe it is. As we say,
yes.
The subject line, the safest extreme sport. So before that, Rudra, let's go to the Facebook and see how many comments do we have and something which is exciting where we can start answering. So we
absolutely.
Have a pretty
but to answer your specific question, yes, it is an expensive sport, costs a lot of money, and you continue to burn money. You know, there's a saying in skydiving. It says if you want to be a millionaire while you're skydiving, you have to start from billionaire. So, yeah.
Okay, and now I think hi Prateek. Prateek has a question. Rudra, why there is no one association and government body on aerosports?
Okay, well. Before getting into the bureaucracy of things,
I think we will keep that for a little later.
I can tell you there is a government body called the Aero Club of India. It's actually a semi-government organization, which is supposedly looking after aerosports in India.
Yeah. So Rudra, when we say it's the safest extreme sport, can you explain that?
Yeah. So, that's the main crux of this conversation. To begin with, you're in an aeroplane. That's absolutely fine. So you can go up and land just like any other location. So it's literally like taking another flight. Why we call it the safest sport, extreme sport, is because the equipment that we use is designed in such a way that it is like a parachute is designed to fly. So a parachute, if it's packed properly, is most likely to open properly and you're most likely to land absolutely safe on the ground. And when you begin to skydive, the equipment that you use is designed to make sure that it is very slow, very simple, and just to the point where you can actually just jump out of a plane, you can fly around in the air for some time. The parachute is going to function the way it is planned to function, and you land back on the ground. And the amount of backup options that we have in the player in the parachute system is also phenomenal. So to give you an example, firstly, we do not use one parachute. The parachute system has two parachute systems.
Okay.
One is called the main parachute, where the main parachute is the one that the person skydiving can pack or somebody who's trained to pack can pack. And that's the one you'd see us open every time in the air and land on. And then there is a secondary parachute, which we also call as the reserve parachute. The reserve parachute is also on your back in the same bag and is designed to open in case you open your parachute and there is a problem with your parachute. There is a system called the three-ring release. So you can actually let go of your main parachute and open your reserve parachute if there is a problem in the air. The reserve parachute is also equipped with something that we call as an automatic activation device. You obviously do not depend on that device, but that device is actually put in there in case you become incapable or incumbent for some reason and you're not able to pull a parachute and you're just falling like a stone through the sky. The the device is going to cut the loop of your reserve parachute, and hopefully you have a parachute on top of you and you land back safe. So yeah, so given that, the fact that we have the whole sky once we jump out of the plane, so we have a lot of space to fly, makes it actually much more, and statistically, skydiving is the safest extreme sport.
I know. Even I think one of our previous conversation, you even told it's much safer than driving a car in the.
So absolutely, the stats say you are more likely to die driving to the drop zone than actually jumping out of a plane.
Correct.
So you're safer jumping from a plane than actually driving to jump out of a plane.
Absolutely. So that's interesting, Rudra. So one thing, when you have told there is a backup parachute and you're 100% safe, I myself have got a second level of confidence. Okay. Mm-hmm. But I'm a person who is so much feared of height. I'm really scared. So what happens to a person like me or anybody who is scared of height? How will they actually jump? Like, how will you make us comfortable? And because I know you, I am with you, or I am with amazing equipment and the great coach, where I can safely jump. But wo jo urge hota hai jump starting ka, can you just explain a little bit how it actually feels and how it can be overcome?
So the reason I have not jumped only once, and I continue jumping. And the reason why most skydivers continue jumping is for the rush that you get once you exit the plane. So that right. that moment. Between fear and freedom is on the edge of the door. So that's something that that's the line that you have to walk for yourself.
Okay.
Having said that, the first time you go for a skydive, you are most likely to be in a tandem skydive. So essentially what you have to worry about is body position. If you see, if you recall the video that I just made, well, do some basic training with you, and what you will actually be doing is just be strapped to somebody like me, or I'm not actually a qualified tandem instructor, but an instructor who's already a skydiver. You'll be attached to someone like them, and they will actually take you through the whole experience with you just actually riding in front of them. So they're responsible for opening the parachute, they're responsible for steering the parachute, they're responsible for pretty much everything. So you actually get to enjoy the complete thrill of skydiving without having to actually worry about your parachute or anything of that sort.
So, Rudra, so when you told you are not qualified as a tandem instructor, so what is the difference between a coach and a tandem instructor? So,
skydiving actually progresses with the amount of jumps you have, the kind of experience you have in the air, and the kind of free fall skills you can exhibit in the air. So, to get a basic license, there are four basic licenses. So, there's license A, B, C, D. What we actually follow, sorry to take you back a little bit, is the USPA, which is the United States Parachuting Association.
Okay.
I've been doing under the USPA guidelines. The drop zone we run here in India is an affiliate of the United States Parachuting Association. So any of our equipments, any of our instructors, any of our SOPs are all come under the same umbrella and are pretty much global standards. USPA is the world's largest skydiving body. So whatever we have and whatever we follow is pretty much at a global scale and is being followed at most places across the globe. So yeah, coming back to licensing. So there is an A license, B license, C license and D license. Obviously, there's a certain number of jumps you have to do and basic courses that you have to go through before achieving each license. And once you have some of these licenses, you can go on to becoming a coach. Further, after 500 jumps and accumulating a lot of free fall and having at least 3 to 4 years in the sport, you have to undergo a training program before you can take up a tandem instructor rating.
Okay, that's quite a huge number.
Yes, absolutely. And the reason for all of this is so that you have the right amount of experience so that somebody else can trust you with their life in the end.
Right, absolutely. Also, Rudra, how many more instructors are there, like coach or tandem instructors in India? Civilian, I know there are many defense personnel there, but civilian,
Right now, the total number of skydivers in India is enough that we can still fit in a WhatsApp group.
Okay.
So We're pretty small. Having said that, the sport, even with civilians, is growing very, very rapidly. I have Instagram messages, almost or Facebook messages almost every other day. We have people on the drop zone who come and do a tandem skydive and then want to become skydivers, people who want to follow skydiving as a career. There are so many people I keep hearing about just because of the drop zone who suddenly send me a message saying, hey, I have a license of skydiving. I learned in Prague or I learned in the US and I'm in India and I want to skydive. So I think the sport is growing very, very rapidly. Okay. With civilians as well.
It's a good news actually.
Yes, it is. It is great news.
Yeah. So.
Yeah.
I think we can now we can go to the comment sessions and see what the other questions. Prateek's question has been answered. Hi Prateek. So there is a body, an association for aerosports. And Nitin, hi Nitin. Nitin is asking, if one has a fear of heights, how much time does a person take before he can jump?
Okay.
Would you like to comment, Rudra?
Yes. To answer your specific question, it may sound as the strangest thing I'd probably say on this call, but I do have a fear of heights myself.
Okay.
Yes, I am myself not comfortable standing in a balcony of a building that is maybe 5 floors and above. Having said that, the fear of height, from what I understand, is also very relative to the height that you can actually measure. So when you're standing on the 10th floor of a balcony, you can actually understand how high up you are and what's going to happen to you when you fall. But when you go 10,000 feet above into the air, then there is no fear because the height, your brain can't immediately understand how high up you are.
I think I can also relate to this, Rudra, because I myself is a private pilot. I have been flying aircrafts. So yeah. I have no fear when I fly aircraft. But as you said, I tried bungee jump once and I couldn't jump. So so that's actually a little asymptote, maybe the perception of the height.
Yep, absolutely.
Ritu has said, extremely thoughtful to acknowledge your mentor. Seriously, even I felt that in the discussion, you didn't forget your mentor. That's an amazing trait, Rudra. I really appreciate that. So Ritu has again one more question is, what is the age limit of skydiving?
Okay, well, that's actually a very interesting question. We get that a lot. There is no age limit to skydiving. George W. Bush Sr. actually did a skydive on his 93rd birthday.
Oh.
So there is actually no age limit to skydiving. However, what we follow here in India, USPA mandates that you have a basic medical fitness certificate from your doctor or from any general physician before you go skydiving. I can, however, do also tell you that the minimum age for skydiving, what we follow here and also recommended by the USPA, is 18 years and above.
Okay.
Minimum age is 18 years and 18 to, as long as your doctor allows you to skydive, you're good to go.
Great. I think many of us had the same question, but that was an interesting question.
We, however, do have a weight limitation for skydiving.
Okay.
For a tandem skydive, what we allow here in India is 90 kgs and below.
Okay. So if you are above 92, then work out and bring down your weight. That's what you say, or okay.
Yeah.
Cool. Rishabh said, hi Rishabh. Is it safe to skydive in India? Rudra, would you like to a little bit? You have already told about the safety of the sport itself, but this is a little more related question, but a different one. Is it safe to skydive in India?
That's a valid question. We do get that information, that question a lot. What I can tell you is that, like I already told you, what we follow here in India is from the US. It's called the United States Parachuting Association. It's the world's largest skydiving body. So all of our equipment, SOPs, instructors, certification processes are all certified by the USPA. So whatever we do with our equipment, whatever we do with our, whatever forms of skydiving we do is all what is followed in the US. So it is at par, if not better, with any global standard that you can get. And the reason why we have a DGC approval here for skydiving, even despite the lack of any licensing here in India, is because we have that affiliation.
That's great, Rishabh. I think you got the, so you know where you have to go to skydive in India. You have to Sky High India is the place where you can actually jump safely. So, hi, Pavitra Vijay Singh. Pavitra has asked, what is your favorite drop zone? I hope Pavitra has jumped before, he understands the drop zones.
Okay. Yes, so my favorite location personally has been, well, that's actually a tough one. But I jumped in a drop zone in Spain. It was called Skydive BCN. It was overlooking half of the view was the sea, and the other half was land. So it was a phenomenal experience. And yeah, my dream skydive here in India would be to skydive over Goa.
So the question is asked by Pavitra. Actually, Pavitra has thanked you. Sky High and Rudra gave me the thrill of my first skydive.
So oh, wow.
He has skydived with you before.
Okay, awesome.
And Shilpa Sharma has asked another question. Hi Shilpa, is insurance compulsory or required for skydiving, being an extreme sport?
Well, I'm not sure if it's compulsory as an extreme, as a policy, but we as a company do follow mandatory insurance for all our skydivers. And this is primarily because life is too precious, and it's not just insurance for life, it's also actually a medical insurance. So if there is a likely possibility for anybody to get injured while during a skydive, they are eligible even for air ambulance pickup from the drop zone.
Awesome. Rudra, is it available? So you provide the insurance, or is it freely available in India?
So it's not, I wouldn't say it's freely available. Yes, insurance, extreme sports insurance is also catching up actually with the sports here in India.
Right.
However, when we charge a customer for skydiving, the insurance is already charged. Uh-huh. Like I said, the company policy that we follow, so every single one of our clients is insured.
Okay, so Rudra, if somebody wants to learn skydiving, because as you said, you have many of the jumpers who come and do a stand-up jump and then continue learning it. So yeah. Can we learn here in India, or if we have to go back to other countries, as you said?
Well, now you are lucky that I didn't have that opportunity, but you have that opportunity. You can very much come and learn skydiving with us. You will be undergoing a program called the AFF. It's known as the Accelerated Free Fall. Okay. It's a comprehensive plan with about 25 jumps before you can get your basic license. Like I said, the A license.
Okay.
The AFF course itself is staggered into 8 parts. So it's 8 different jumps wherein you try to achieve different things in the air. So after your first tandem, you will be going through rigorous ground training where you understand procedures of the air, procedures of the plane, boarding, jumping, exiting. When is a good time to jump? When is a good time not to jump, etc., etc. So a lot of ground training before you actually go up. The first time you do go up, which is for your first jump of the EFF, you are actually being assisted by two people like myself who also have parachutes on their back, and they're holding you from either side. So you're not let go of at any point of time during the free fall experience. And you're basically just... we just try to ensure that you have understood what a good body position is, so that you're flying comfortably through the sky and you're able to reach out, check your parachute, pull your parachute, you're aware of your altitude, etc. And then so basically that's the first jump, and then as we progress into the AFF program, you start doing bit by bit learning more and more. Once you've cleared your AFF, you start jumping more with more people. You have to jump with coaches, jump with other guys, or jump solo till you have an A license. Only when you have an A license is that you are qualified to go and jump with other skydivers. Okay. So your A license actually makes you eligible to take a license to a drop zone, show it at a drop zone, and then be like, okay, I'm going to go and jump. Say you are a live skydiver and I'm a skydiver, so we can go and jump.
Okay, so usually how many jumps, or how many days, or how many, what is the duration to get a...
So like the basic license course is about 25 jumps.
Okay.
You could take anything conservatively a week to maybe 10 to 15 days to finish your basic course.
Okay.
Given the weather condition is good and you're able to pull off the requisite number of jumps in the day. But this is a very, very basic license. You also learn to pack your only your main parachute. So the reserve parachute, like I said, is not packed by everybody. You have to be a FAA certified rigger to be able to pack a reserve parachute. So not everybody can pack a reserve parachute. And every 6 months, the parachute has to be opened and repacked. In fact, until last year, the reserve parachutes of the equipment that we were using were all being packed in Dubai because we did not have any FAA certified riggers here in India. This year, however, we've one of our team members went to the US and got the rigger rating. So now we can he can pack our reserve parachutes as well.
That's amazing. That's amazing. But that's interesting to understand also, Rudra. So as you said, when every jump, the reserve parachute will not be opened. So nothing to worry. So only in case if it is opened, then you need somebody to pack it back. Right?
Absolutely. Like I said, the system is designed so beautifully that the reserve parachute and the main parachute do not come in contact with each other.
Okay.
Which is why the system also has the release system for the reserve for the main parachute. So before you deploy a reserve parachute, you actually just pull one handle and the main parachute just leaves the bag completely. So you have to, after you land, you have to physically go and fetch that parachute from somewhere a few kilometers away and get it back. This is done so that the main parachute does not entangle with the reserve parachute when the reserve parachute opens.
Awesome. So when you jump, always you have this backup of reserve parachute, but is there any chance that you know the reserve parachute can also go wrong or something like that?
Well, like I said, it is the safest extreme sport. It's not 100% safe. There is incidents and accidents that do occur. The rate of these accidents are very minimal. It can happen due to multiple reasons, but in my experience in the last 7 years, I have not had a reserve ride. I've only been jumping my main parachute. I've never actually had to open a reserve parachute. But from what I understand from fellow skydivers, reserve parachute works absolutely.
Okay. And Rudra, what is the difference from having a course here in India and in US? Is it different in any way or is it equally good?
Well, the course I hope is equally good because what we will be issuing to you is a USPA license. So we will actually just be conducting the program for you where we will be doing the training. We will be filling out the requisite paperwork and sending it back to the US. Okay. So when you do get a license for skydiving, it will be a USPA license. It's not an Indian license. So you are recognized globally and you are eligible to go and jump in any drop zone that is recognized or affiliated with the United States Parachuting Association.
Is there any other drop zones other than Sky High in India where it's approved?
I've heard of people trying to do some camps for skydiving where they try to get together people. I personally helped with a lot of these camps because I want this sport to grow as much as possible. But to answer the specific question, no, there is no other drop zone currently operating in India except for Sky High. We are fortunate to be based out of, we are pretty close to Delhi. So we do have an influx of a lot of customers coming in over and over again. So yeah, but I do hope in the next 5 or 10 years there is a lot of drop zones. So I'll give you some stats, Renzi.
Yes, please.
The US has more than 300 drop zones, and it's a big country. But Europe alone has about 700 drop zones, most of which operate only very limited time of the year because you know, it's really cold over there. South Africa, or the African subcontinent, for instance, which is much closer to our kind of you know, dispensable income, has about 52 odd drop zones.
Okay.
China had 0 drop zones till 5 years ago, and now has 14. Just the last 5 years.
Okay.
So the speed at which the sport is growing, I mean, it's inevitable. You know, any major city around the globe that you travel to, be it a Sydney, a New York, a California, like a San Francisco, or any big city that you go to in the world, Dubai, you know, Skydive Dubai is the crown jewel of Dubai tourism. So I hope that you know, India can also look at skydiving the same way. It is phenomenal.
Is there other than USPA? Is there any other organization which is equally good in the world?
Yes, absolutely. So there is the British Parachute Association. There is the Australian, I'm not sure what it's called, but I do know that there is an Australian Parachuting Association as well. The British Parachuting Association, because of the size of the country, is pretty limited to the UK. But what is followed globally and most recognized across Europe, India, or even all over the world is the United States Parachuting Association.
Okay.
So it is pretty much the largest skydiving body in the world.
Something like we have PADI for scuba diving.
Absolutely, yeah. But I'm sure countries do have their own licensing system as well. But they may not be global.
But does India has any kind of a licensing system? I know for aircrafts and ballooning there is, but do they have for skydiving?
Nothing as of now. I hope someday they will, but nothing as of now.
Okay, let's see some questions. Hi Mayur. Mayur has dived from 16,500 feet over Fuchs Glacier in New Zealand.
Wow.
So Mayur is saying my right ear didn't pop for 6 months after that jump.
Okay. Well, it must be landing in a height itself. So if you jump, if you're very high above sea level, that problem can occur. Yes.
Right. Mayur, you must be brave man. He's saying fear didn't come into play.
Wow.
What was the weight restriction in India? Mayur, I think weight restriction 92 is what Rudra told. Rudra, 92 is the restriction, right?
Yes.
Yeah, it is 92. Who is the... Okay, some Vam Sangam. Hi Vam. Vam, question is, who is the youngest skydiver in India right now?
Well, I'll have to look that up, but there is a lot of people after me who've taken through skydiving. I've met so many people. I was in Russia last year. I met people who were skydiving. Pretty kids who were maybe 21, 20. I do know when we have people who come in and get their license and come in to skydive with us at Narnaul. They're much younger than me. So right now there are a lot of young people who are taking to skydive.
Right. Hi Adhiraj, why Sky High is not starting AFF course?
Okay. So we have not started AFF courses for the last 2 years. We've started the courses now. Actually, Adhiraj, I'd just like to update you. Please log on to our site. There's more information about it. So we wanted to slowly progress into skydiving as a team. So we wanted to understand and ensure that the operation is smooth and comfortable before we introduce any training programs. The training programs also require a larger infrastructure, a better landing area, and a lot more facility and equipment before we can just get into starting training. So because we spent a lot of time with regulation in India, we wanted to ensure that the right regulation is in place. We have the right infrastructure in place. When we were operating in Aligarh, we were sharing the airspace with a flying training organization. So there was other activity in the air, so we could not do any training programs.
Okay.
Now, having moved to Narnaul and having the right infrastructure, we've had AFF programs and static line jumps over the last year. So we hope to do a lot.
Right. AFF is the one which you told, the accelerator free fall.
Yes.
It's the same
thing,
right?
That's the basic requirement you have to undergo to try and get an A license.
Okay. So Pavitra has again another question. Can people with individual licenses come and use the facility for jumps?
Yes, absolutely. Our facility is open to skydivers. We in fact encourage skydivers to keep current. So we encourage them to come, rent our equipment if they need to, but continue jumping. One of the most important things about the sport is to make sure that you stay current, so that you're comfortable with your equipment, with the way they are operating procedures, etc. So we do encourage a lot of people who are with equipment to come in and jump with us.
Right, and Nitin has an interesting question. Nitin Gura, how much time is the person in the air, and can you explain the experience once a person jumps?
Well, I can try to explain the experience, but you have to experience it firsthand to really understand what it is. What I can tell you is that once you jump from 10,000 feet, the parachute is opened by the instructor at about 5,500 feet. So it is roughly 30 to 40 seconds of pure free fall in the air. It is too liberating to be able to explain in simple words what it's like. Like I said, it is a very thin line between fear and freedom. And once you're out of the plane and into the blue sky, you are literally flying and you're free. And like you'll see in the video that I already showed you, I may show you some more videos, right, and you will realize that the smile on the faces is so big that you can actually not just only see teeth, because it is really, really phenomenal to understand and to realize that yes, the human body is capable of actually flying through the sky.
Right. Hi Manish. Manish Soni has a question. Post COVID-19, how you will operate tandem jump because instructor and participant will be too close. Okay, so he asked the question on social distancing.
Yes.
Do you want it to be a little later with the, along with that, or you want to explain now?
Apps whenever you want me to.
I think you can go.
We have not yet started skydiving. Our season in India starts from September all the way through March. So we still have a good 3 months before our actual season starts. However, SOPs as far as the USPA is concerned have come into play, where you'll be wearing a mask and gloves, and there will be thermal screening for every client that comes in before they actually go for a skydive. And needless to say, the sanitization processes that are followed before skydive or any at the airport itself.
Okay, thank you, Rudra. That's information is very important actually. It is something everybody is looking forward to know. Puni has a question. Do we need to undergo any medical checkup before skydiving? Yes, Puni, Rudra has already told. And person with high BP can do this. I think the doc. Yeah, Rudra, please.
Yeah, your doctor will have to. I'm not qualified to answer that question. So you will have to take specifically to your doctor. If you're under medication and your BP is controlled with medication, I think you should be fine.
Yeah. Ramzan. Hi, Ramzan. Ramzan has the question. Is it possible to take one extra person or a cameraman to shoot video?
No, absolutely not. The only people allowed in the plane are people who are qualified from the plane. So the plane itself actually flies without a door. The plane we use. So it's pretty much just, you're just sitting on the edge of a door of a plane. And if you go out, then it's a point of no return. So once you step out, or if you try to get something if you try to lean out of the plane, chances are you'll fly out. And if you don't have a parachute, it'll be a hard landing.
So when did you dive first and at what age? And what actually comes up at that time in your, probably I think Poonam wants to know, in your mind when you were up in the sky?
Okay, so my first skydive was in the year 2012, as I already told you, about I think 21 years of age.
Okay.
20 years of age, yeah. So that was my first skydiving experience. I actually signed up for the course directly before actually leaving from India for the US. So I was very nervous, to be very truthful. I had not even seen a drop zone or what a skydiving facility looks like. I had no idea. Whatever I'd seen was only pure videos. When I left the plane, everything froze, is from what I can remember. But the point, I think it was not in my first jump, but in my consecutive, my actual training consecutive jumps, where all my tension in my head actually just converted into understanding that I was actually skydiving. Like I'd gone through 2-3 jumps absolutely fine. I'd done everything the way it was supposed to be done, but I was still like flying like very stiff. And something happened in the air. One of my instructors who was in front of me actually just pecked me in the air and just did this. And that moment I can even still remember if I close my eyes. And it just changed everything about skydiving for me, because that was the moment, even having done 3-4 skydives, that I realized that I was actually out of a plane and I was flying in the blue sky. So yeah, phenomenal.
So excited. It's actually, this is called inspiring, listening to you itself feels like, we have to dive.
Yes, absolutely, Renzi. I think everybody, like they say, life is too short. Everybody should and experience skydiving for sure.
Nitin Bhargava, can we also do a course in skydive in your institute? Yes, Nitin, definitely you can do a course. Vidra has already mentioned that. Pavitra, wow, the sounds amazing. Goa drop zone will be fabulous to have. Do we have a drop zone in Goa?
No, we do not have anything in Goa, but I hope that someday, sooner than later, we do have something on a destination like Goa.
Okay, Mayur has the question, what would be the cost of the course or the training?
Okay, so like I said, skydiving is an expensive sport. Having said that, the cost of an AFF course with us is about 1,75,000 rupees. The cost of a total A license, which is up to 25 jumps, will roughly be around 3,84,000. This includes all your training, all the equipment that you will be using during your training, all your 25 jumps, the instructor's fees, the course fees, the aircraft fees, the airport fees, everything is included. Only your food and stay at the drop zone is not included.
Okay, so Rudra, when you said this, is it important that, you know, a person who comes for the training has to buy the parachute?
No. This is only rentals for the parachute. It's absolutely okay. Not. We'll be using our equipment, so it includes gear rental. The parachute itself would cost that much money.
Okay.
Good parachute system costs between $6,000 to $8,000 at the least.
Okay. It's a huge amount, actually.
Absolutely.
At what height skydiving in India happens? Anchit, hi Anchit.
So we jump from around 10,000 feet. Currently, that's the highest we are allowed to skydive from in India. Mm-hmm. Globally, you have the option of going up to 13,000 feet. Some drop zones, very few drop zones in the world, also go up to 18,000 feet.
Okay, there was one question actually for you. What was your maximum height of jump?
Yes, I have gone as about 14,000 something feet. Yeah.
Okay. At the same time, there is another question from Pony. What's your favorite sport, adventure sport, other than skydiving?
Like I already told you that I do fly a paramotor as well. So it's something that keeps me, that's something I do as a hobby. I don't follow it commercially. And so every time I'm not able to go from up to down, I try to go from down to up. So I take my soar up into the sky.
Yeah, how much fund is needed to be a solo skydiver? Are there any scholarship? No, I think that's the same AFF course which Rudra has mentioned. And there is an additional question, are any scholarships? I'm not sure. Rudra, will you be?
No, I do not know or I'm aware of any scholarships. But what I can tell you is that there is a program in New Zealand, which is called the Diploma in Skydiving. I know one of my instructors who's jumping here with us has actually followed that program. So if you want to pursue skydiving as a career and want to take it seriously, there is a Diploma in Skydiving, which includes 200 skydives and some experience as an intern at a drop zone. So yes, there is a Diploma in Skydiving that you can pursue in New Zealand.
Yeah, maybe that's a kind of an academic course or?
It's a mix of academics and actual skydiving.
Okay. That's interesting to know. I hope now that you got your query cleared. As you said earlier, you have one drop zone in Aligarh and one in Narnol. So which is the actual active drop zone where all your activities happen?
We are now located in Narnol. That is the permanent location now. Like I mentioned earlier, we were sharing the airspace with another flying training organization. So there was a lot more activity in that airspace except for skydiving. And for the sport to grow, we needed the airspace dedicated to ourselves. So Narnol as of now is dedicated to skydiving. We are at good enough distance from the main airport to be able to go up to 10,000 feet and use the entire airspace to fly.
So is there any restrictions in India for skydiving, Rudra? Just curious to understand, because is it only because of the amount of permissions required it's not flourishing much, or is there any other reason also?
So I wouldn't say it's not flourishing much. The fact that I'm sitting here with you goes to show that yes, people are understanding skydiving. I've not heard
So
of a
when I
Facebook
said
Live.
flourishing much, as you said, it's only one USP upload drops on in India
Yes,
and a
actually,
country like this.
the idea of skydiving is still very alien to the government and the regulator. And because we use an aircraft to jump out of, we are still regulated by the DGCA, which is the
Okay.
Director of Civil Aviation.
Okay, so the
And
major restriction is on the aircraft more than the dive itself.
absolutely, because the modification of the aircraft for skydiving, the pilot for skydiving, etc., is all regulated by the DGCA. Skydiving as a sport, there is still no regulation in India that we can follow. There is only tourism guidelines for the conduct of adventure sports, which includes skydiving now, that you can follow. Having said that, DGCA also in the last 4, 5, 6 years of us continuously applying for permissions, etc., have started taking a larger view of the subject. And understanding what exactly it is, what is the global standards, what is it that we are following, what is happening. Now that the word is going out, we have more and more people coming in and skydiving. People are understanding that yes, there is an opportunity and a space available within the civilian side also where something like this can happen. And then the other problem is that the regulation is designed by the DGCA. However, the location where we skydive is a state government location. So whether it's Aligarh or Narnaul in Haryana, the trip itself is owned by a state government. So you have the central government to explain and give you the permission, but you also need the state government in your support to be able to let you use an airfield for aerosports. And then there is the basic fear of what if something goes wrong. So that's something that only with time you can contest. We are very fortunate. We have 100% safety track record. Like I already mentioned to you, we are very careful with what we do. We follow all the basic protocols and all the basic safety recommendations of the United States Parachuting Association. All our instructors are certified by the United States Parachuting Association, and all our reserve parachutes, every 6 months, if the person is not available in India, like till before this, actually travel to a place where a reserve parachute rigger is available to pack them. So yeah, in terms of safety, we follow the highest protocols and safety standards.
Great, awesome, Rudra. So I think it's a shortage of time. Pretty much we have answered almost all the questions. And if we, in case we, I have missed any questions or comments, don't worry. I will try to get those answered from Rudra itself. I'll ask his permission and ask his answer from him, and I'll be able to try to put it in the reply to the comments.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Renzi, what I do want to, however, do is
Yeah.
show you how life at a drop zone looks like.
Yeah.
Why is it that we feel so excited about just going up in a plane and jumping again and again? So I have one more video for you. I hope
Please.
that that's okay, and I hope the viewers enjoy it.
Yeah.
So yeah, quickly look that up. Okay, here we go. That's
That's you. This gave a very good closing. In fact, again, you made us more excited.
Yes, so I'd like to invite you over to come to Narnaul, skydive with us, and to all the viewers.
Thank you very much, Rudra, for this was an amazing session. It was great, interactive, and the videos you showed was really exciting. And above everything, it was super informative. There were a lot of questions and doubts around the sport. You have solved a lot of it. So thank you.
I'm available anytime you need more information.
Yeah. Thank you.